Tater, Mark Preston, Dana Bash also joining me, Kayleigh McEnany, Donald Trump supporter and conservative columnist, Bakari Sellers, Clinton supporter, former member of the South Carolina House of Representatives, Paris Denard for Trump and former White House Black Outreach Director for President George W. Bush, and Maria Cardona. Thanks to all for being with me. Let me just start with you, Mark Preston, here. New Hampshire, obviously at this point, the electoral, that's over, but that's still a victory for her to be able to say she has New Hampshire,
right?
For her supporters. I mean, I heard Maria Cardona over there saying, yes, this matters to a lot
and
of people
the
when they look at the moral, their moral situation here.
Yeah, I mean, look, I mean, she lost, though. I mean, the bottom line is and she's lost twice, and she's got nowhere to go from this. To Maria's point, though, they did pick up a Senate seat in New Hampshire, which is critical because Democrats are going to have a lot of trouble in Congress going into 2018, where the odds are stacked against them. No matter what happens in the Trump presidency in the next couple of years, Democrats, you know, have an uphill battle, but you know, the fact of the matter is she wasn't able to get it done. She wasn't able to excite her base in key states. And,
right.
You know, so she did pick it up today. They'll find a little solace, but still.
And we're going to talk much more, obviously, with a definitive Electoral College win. But the popular vote right now still indicating that she will have that. That split, of course, we've only seen once this century with Al Gore. Mm-hmm. But let me talk about today, David, what we saw with the market. Dow futures were plunging last night. Traders outside the United States sending it down nearly 900 points. It closed up today, resoundingly so, okay? Resoundingly so. 1,000-point swing. After all the doom and gloom, you heard people out there saying all these bad things would happen in the market. Today, the exact opposite on a Trump victory.
It's good news for Donald Trump, just as it was early on for the Brexit voters. You know, people who they saw the markets go get better than people had expected. Well, you pointed out before we came on the air, a big part of that swing was the initial reaction, the negative reaction, came in the foreign markets, where there's a lot of jittery investors and there's a lot of terror among foreign policy people. But when the U.S. markets opened, that's when the swing came. I think that's a big part of it. But it's also true that people, investors here, are taking a hard look at his economic plan and the fact that he is going to provide fiscal stimulus that they think will be on a large order, starting with tax cuts and then investments and infrastructure. Both those things add fuel to the economy and goose it up. You could actually get higher interest rates. And as you know, investors look at all of that and say, that's good news. Let's support it.
And Dana, you know, when you look at what happened today, It was a country showing that people could rise to the best. And it started with Donald Trump at 3 o'clock in the morning.
It did.
When he came out and he was gracious and he was generous and he reached out. Clinton took about 9 hours. And one would presume she was probably physically unable to come out when she first heard the news that she had lost. When she did speak, though, there was a lot of emotion in her voice as well. Here she is.
I know how disappointed you feel because I feel it too. And so do tens of millions of Americans who invested their hopes and dreams in this effort. This is painful, and it will be for a long time.
Raw and personal.
Absolutely.
The side of her we didn't see this election.
Exactly. And it's the side of her we saw after she lost in 2008. It's the side of her we saw after, within that primary process, she lost the Iowa caucuses and went on to New Hampshire. And she had that famous moment where she got emotional.
Right.
Now, I'm not saying that, you know, she needs to show her emotions on her sleeve, because if she did that all the time, then she would have other problems. But what she did do there was appear to show her real self. And that is always what happens. It doesn't matter who you are, what gender, what party, when a candidate loses, especially loses this big and in this much of a public way, and you know, in this case, a big surprise for her, all of your defenses are down and you have nothing but your raw self. And I think that was so clear today. Mm-hmm. And it always happens. It's inevitable that people say, where was that person? Where was that candidate? And it's because they're not guarded in that moment.
Right, right. And then, and you, when you know the winner and the loser, it's easy to have empathy
exactly.
for the side if you were on the other side.
Exactly.
See, today you had, you know, George W. Bush, George H.W. Bush, Mitt Romney. Obviously, I know you didn't support Trump. Those are people more along the lines of where your politics
right.
are. But even on the other side, you had Elizabeth Warren, Nancy Pelosi saying they're going to work with Donald Trump. Elizabeth Warren.
Right.
I mean, those two have said some of the nastiest things about each other of anybody in this race.
Well, it turns out on the day after the election, grown-ups come back. I mean, the election really does change you. People take it very personally. Most of us at our heart are partisan, and we've all been fighting and working for a really long time on either end of it or covering it. But at the end of the day, the country still needs running. And so I actually thought it was really nice to see people from both wings, progressive wing, the right that didn't support Donald Trump, come out and say, listen, we got to grow up. We've got to yep. come together. This is going to be important. We still have a lot of challenges. And as, you know, crazy as this turn of events is, this is the reality. Let's move on and get to work.
So, Kayla, let's talk about this, right? Definitive electoral victory for Donald Trump. But when you look at the popular vote, Hillary Clinton is ahead there as of latest count. Even in states that Trump won, Pennsylvania, 68,000 votes out of millions of votes cast, right? You could call it a mandate, or you could call it a deeply divided country that needs outreach. Will Trump be able to do the latter?
Yes, and I agree with you entirely that this is a country that does need outreach. There are deep divisions here. And Donald Trump, when he came out last night and was very big in that moment, and he praised Hillary Clinton and he praised her hard work. And then he went on to say something that I think is really important. He said, this is a movement of people of all races and all religions. And today I've had a few anecdotal encounters with Hillary supporters who said, you know what, I can get behind ethics reform. I can get behind taking my government back. That actually makes a lot of sense to me. When I step back and take the partisanship out of it, what Donald Trump is saying makes sense, and I think a lot of people are going to wake up of all races and religions and say they are part of the movement of taking the government back.
So, Bakari, that Kayleigh's saying she sees it as the outreach is needed. Trump's campaign manager and Paul Ryan don't see it that way exactly. Let's just play what they had to say today.
He's being given a mandate.
What Donald Trump just pulled off is an enormous political feat. He just earned a mandate.
Okay. Mandate. Twice.
Whoa. We've had a difference of opinion of definitions of words throughout this campaign, and we'll have another difference right now because it's not a mandate. Barack Obama came in with 350 electoral votes in his first race. He came in with 330 in his second. Hillary Clinton actually has a popular vote. Mm-hmm. But so a mandate, whatever we want to call it, I don't think it's that. But he does come in today as the winner. And in politics, all that matters is who wins the race.
That's right.
It doesn't matter if you get to 270.
Not about the margin. It's about the victory.
Not about the margin. So Donald Trump is the president of the United States. I would do everything I can to make sure he's successful, contrary to Mitch McConnell, the way he treated Barack Obama or anybody else. Any Democrat that will not do anything he can to make sure he's successful is not doing the country a service. However, I will say that today is a devastating day for many people when they woke up this morning. My daughter was inconsolable this morning. For many Arab Americans and immigrants and African Americans, many young women, today was a very difficult day. And the reason being is because there are many of us who will do everything we can to make sure Donald Trump is successful, but still believe he does not represent what's best for the country, does not represent who we are. And Donald Trump, his biggest burden is to unify this country. The conundrum is last night he showed that he didn't have to unify the country to be successful. So I don't know why anyone wants me to believe that he'll unify the country today.
Paris.
Look, at the end of the day, there are a lot of fragile communities that are suffering. They are black, they are brown, they are in Appalachia, they are Republican, they are Democrat. And when you look at this decisive victory, and I think it's a mandate, you look at the people who said, we need change, we need somebody who's going to help us. We need jobs. Student loan debt is out of control. And these people are the ones that came to vote. The pollsters missed it. They couldn't poll them. They didn't talk to them. They didn't understand where they came from. But there was an undercurrent of people supporting Donald Trump who found him to be aspirational. 8% were African American, which is better than what Mitt Romney did. The National Diversity Coalition for Trump was out there from the beginning doing these positive things to help move this narrative. And I believe Mr. Trump is going to continue this engagement and be the leader that the people right. voted for him know that he can be.
All right, we're going to talk about the polls and exactly how this happened in just a moment. Next, though, how Donald Trump redrew the electoral map, because he truly did. John King breaking it down at the Magic Wall. Plus, what Trump's loyal supporters got right.
Was your faith ever shaken? Did you think the polls were ever wrong?
Oh, I thought the polls were wrong from the beginning.
And Donald Trump's close friend of nearly 40 years was with Trump last night as the results came in. Tom Barrack is my guest out front. And we're watching anti-Trump protests across the country tonight. We'll be right back.